In the last podcast on Hebrews 13, you mentioned judgment for sins of both believers and unbelievers to come. Concerning the believer's judgment, does that mean sins committed by believers after they have accepted Christ unto initial justification, even if repented of before physical death or judged in the eschaton?
Now, I have to admit that the wording of this question is difficult. I mean, unto justification before physical death. You know. What I think the question is asking is, are sins that believers commit after believing, are those sins judged in the eschaton, you know, like at the judgment seat of Christ or something, you know, in the last days, you know, or sins that believers commit after believing judged in, later on? My answer is no. Sin was judged at the cross. My sins, I was born in 1963. My sins were covered by the sacrifice of Christ. My sins were all future with respect to the cross event, but it still covered them. I was born long after the cross. The sacrifice of the cross isn't, therefore, bound by time. If it was, passages like John 3:16 and 17 are bogus. And so is most of the biblical talk about the cross, since it is written to post-cross event people. Okay, so we don't have a chronological or time limitation to what's going on at the cross. Sin was judged at the cross, period. That's when it's judged. A sinning now is a reality, but again, all of my sins, and they were real and still are real, they were all covered by the cross event. The fact that I was born long after the cross doesn't matter. So sinning now is a reality. Again, 1 John 1:10, every believer still sins. Sin does not result in the loss of salvation because salvation wasn't gained and couldn't be gained by sinlessness, and that which cannot be gained by moral perfection cannot be lost by moral imperfection. Rather, sin now results in what it has always resulted in: self-destruction, harm to other people, plus additional factors created by being in relationship to God through Christ. It results in being unuseful to God, in God's plan, so we become tools that don't get used. It results in a loss of blessing. Again, I like the word blessing instead of the word reward, by the way. I don't need to get to me being blessed in eternal life, you know, in the context when I get my life review, you know, that sort of thing, you know, when we're with the Lord, to be blessed just feels a whole lot more, just feels better than I'm going to get a prize, you know. I just like the word blessing. Maybe that's my own hang up here, but again, we will know then how God wanted to use us and how we could have been used, but we weren't. So we will suffer some loss, but again, every man will receive some commendation. 1 Corinthians 4, verse 5. So that's how I would answer that question.